Hello everyone, today we are going to conduct the Jeener diode experiment. In the Jeener diode, first we will see the forward bias. Forward bias of the Jeener diode. This is the Jeener diode circuit diagram. In this diagram, if you see the diagram, there is a supply and it is the Jeener diode. The Jeener diode, the voltage across the Jeener diode, we will measure by using this voltmeter. The voltmeter range is 0 to 50 volts or 0 to 30 volts we can take. And it is ammeter. This ammeter is used to measure the current passing through this Jeener diode. The range of the this ammeter we are taking 0 to 200 milliamps, and it is a 1 kilo ohm resistor that is connected in series with the Jeener diode. Now let's connect the Jeener diode, the circuit diagram connections on the breadboard. So first I connected 1 kilo ohm resistor. For this 1 kilo ohm second terminal, I am connecting Jeener diode anode. So if you see the this is called as a Jeener diode. This black color indicates the cathode, and this remaining color indicates the anode of the Jeener diode. Now here, anode of the Jeener diode is connected to second terminal of the resistor, 1 kilo ohm resistor. So I am connecting like this here. Connecting means we should connect vertically only here. These both are connected. As these both terminals are connected, I am connecting vertically here. Okay, as these both are connected, that's why I am connecting vertically. Now if we complete the remaining circuit, RPS positive. If you see the RPS positive, this is called as the RPS positive. This is the RPS positive. RPS positive is connected to 1 kilo ohm first terminal. Okay, 1 kilo ohm first terminal. Okay, RPS positive is connected to 1 kilo ohm first terminal. Connected means we should connect vertically. Next, this RPS negative is connected to ground. This is the RPS negative. RPS negative, I am connecting to the ground. Okay, ground terminals we should connect here. Okay, I am connecting to the ground. Next, this part completed. Next, we will connect the voltmeter. Voltmeter positive is connected to Jeener diode anode. Okay, this is the voltmeter positive. This voltmeter positive is connected to Jeener diode. This junction only anode, and this voltmeter negative is connected to Jeener diode anode. Cathode. Here it is cathode. Across the Jeener diode, we should connect the voltmeter. I am connecting the voltmeter across the Jeener diode. Okay, so if you see the these terminals here, in this terminal, how many terminals are connected? Resistor second terminal and the Jeener diode anode and this voltmeter positive. Three terminals are connected. That's why if you see the junction point, there are three terminals. One, two, three terminals are connected to junction point. Now, next one, we will connect ammeter here. Ammeter positive is connected to this Jeener diode cathode. Okay, that's why if it is connected means we should connect vertically. So this is ammeter terminal. Ammeter positive is connected to cathode of the Jeener diode. This ammeter positive, I am connecting to the cathode of the Jeener diode. Next, ammeter negative, I am connecting to the ground. Ammeter negative, I am connecting to the ground. Okay, ammeter negative, I am connecting to the ground. Here, this, instead of connecting this ammeter negative to the ground and this RPS negative to the ground, you can connect directly RPS negative to the ammeter negative directly. That is your wish. We will get the same values. This is the circuit diagram of the Jeener diode that is in the forward bias. Now, by increasing the RPS values, now we will see what are the values we will get, that we will see now. Now, I switched on the two meters here, ammeter, voltmeter and the RPS. I switched on this. Now I am increasing the RPS value slowly. Now I am increasing the RPS value. Now we are getting the, in voltmeter I am getting 0.1. At 0.1 we are getting the zero value here. Okay, next, if it is 0.2, if it is 0.2, then also we are getting the zero. Now I am slowly increasing the RPS value. If the RPS value is increasing continuously up to 0.3 volts, it is, the voltmeter is showing 0.3 volts. At 0.3 forward voltage, but the forward current, that is the Jeener diode forward current, is 0. Again, I am increasing the RPS voltage up to, we will get the 0.4 volts in the voltmeter. Okay, at 0.4 volts also, we are getting the ammeter value is 0. Okay, now if we increase the RPS value further, okay, up to here we are getting the 0.5 volts. Here we are getting the 0.5 volts, but there is no change in the ammeter value. So from this we can say that the Jeener diode will not conduct up to 0.5 volts. Okay, so up to 0.5 volts there is no conduction in the ammeter. There is no conduction on the Jeener diode. The ammeter is showing 0 only. Now if I increase further,
it exactly. So if you increase at 0.6 volts, there is a slight increase in the current here at 0.6 volts. So it exactly 0.6 volts, where there is a small increase in the current here. Okay, there is a small increase in, that is 0.1 milliampere of current we are getting. Again, if you increase further, okay, at 0.7 volts, okay, at 0.7 volts, the ammeter is drastically, the ammeter value increasing drastically. So from this we can say that the cut-in voltage of this diode is, this is the silicon diode, it is a, we are getting at zero, at exactly 0.7 volts, it starts conducting. Okay, the cut-in voltage of this is, of this particular diode is 0.7 volts. So the cut-in voltage is nothing but the voltage where the diode starts conducting is called as a cut-in voltage. Okay, so it is a 0.7 volts and the ammeter value, this is the ammeter value, it starts increasing. Okay, now if you see the values here, if you see the values here, these are the values we are getting. Up to 0.5 volts, there is no conduction. Okay, at 0.6 volts, there is a small increase in the value. At 0.7 volts, the current increases drastically. Okay, so this is about the GNR diode forward bias. Now we will see about the reverse bias of the GNR diode. Okay, if you see the GNR diode circuit, just reverse the supply terminals. So here it is RPS positive. So it is RPS positive and it is the RPS negative. The RPS positive here, RPS negative is connected to 1 kilo ohm first terminal. Just from forward bias to reverse bias, just I am interchanging the RPS terminals here. Just I am interchanging the RPS terminals. If you interchange the RPS terminals, we will get the circuit like this. RPS positive is connected to ground now. RPS positive is connected to ground. RPS positive is connected to ground and RPS negative is connected to 1 kilo ohm first terminal. Now we will vary the RPS here. Now we will see the what are the responses we will get in the reverse bias. Now that GNR diode is in reverse bias condition. Now we'll see. So here at GNR diode, at reverse voltage is 1 volt. At reverse voltage is, I am taking the 1 volt, but the current it is showing 0 only. Now I am increasing the RPS. Up to we will get 2 volts in the voltmeter, up to it will show 2 volts here. At reverse voltage is 2 volts, at reverse voltage of 2 volts, but the reverse current is 0. Now we will increase the RPS continuously again, up to 3 volts in the voltmeter. Okay, reverse voltage is 3 volts here. Sorry, reverse voltage is 3 volts. Now at reverse voltage of 3 volts, again the reverse current is 0 only. Now, if I increase the RPS further, but at this 4 volts, it exactly at the 4 volts, the reverse voltage is at 4 volts, there is a slight increase in the ammeter here. At 4 volts, the current it is, we are getting 0.8 milliamps. Now, again, if you increase the further here, okay, so after 4.7, at 4.7 volts, okay, we are getting the current is 9 volts. Again, if you increase the RPS further, okay, so here RPS, we are increasing the RPS value and the current value is changing, but there is no change in this voltmeter value. Okay, so it is 4.8 only. Okay, again here continuously I am increasing the RPS value and the continuously the value is changing, the reverse current is changing continuously, but here there is no change in the voltage value. Voltage value is 4.8 to 4.9, it is fluctuating. So from this we can say that the voltage value is constant. Okay, even if you increase the RPS value continuously, your current value is increasing. Okay, so if you see the values here the reverse voltage is up to 3 volts, there is no conduction. At exactly 4 volts, there is an increasing in the current value in the reverse direction. But at exactly at 4.7 volts, we are increasing the RPS value continuously, but the voltage value is not changing. It is constant. But the current value is increasing, but the voltage is not changing, it is a constant. From this we can say that GNR diode acts as a voltage regulator in the reverse bias, because the voltage is constant even if you increase the applied voltage continuously. Here voltage is constant but the current is changing. If you see the characteristics, we will get the forward and reverse bias characteristics like this. These are the forward bias characteristics and these are the reverse bias characteristics. After 0.7 volts, the current is increasing drastically. But in the reverse bias, after 4.8 volts, the voltage is constant but the current is increasing. These are the characteristics of the forward and reverse bias of the GNR diode.